Let's say that you have a bookshelf. How do you sort books? Probably by topic, then author, and maybe title. Or maybe author and title. Why are you sorting them like that? That's because in this way, all similar books are grouped together. And when you're looking for something, it is easy to spot where the group is. And then you can look through them, find the one you had in mind. For database tables, you should apply the same logic. Let's say that we have a table of books. We have a few columns like author, title, category, publisher, published date, and the ISBN. If we put the books on the shelf, sorting them by author and title, it's easy to understand that queries like "give me all the books by this author" will be fast. And if we want to find a series of books starting with the same title, we can quickly find the author group and then skip quickly through the books since we know they are sorted by title. To find a specific title will be the same thing. We quickly find a group and then quickly skip through the books. But what if we ask a completely different question? Like, give me all the books published in this year. The only way to do that is to look at each book and check the publication year. And this operation will be slower and slower as more books you have. In database term, this is called a full table scan. But what if we reorganize our bookshelf to be sorted by publication year? Well, now it's super fast to find the book of a specific year and even between ranges. By knowing the user's pattern, we can optimize the data layout to speed up queries. But again, if we change our query pattern to something like "give me all the books by this author," we now have to check each book since the publication date grouping does not help us. So, how can we solve this problem? Let's dive into indexing a bit more. Let's say that we have a table with three columns. A is our primary key. In general, databases organize the data in sorted pages, with the sort given by the key. This gives us something similar to the grouping we have done before with the bookshelves. And having the data sorted means that the database can perform a binary search. If we try to look up a specific row, the index will be used. Even using the like operator, the index will be used. But only if we are searching for a prefix. On a suffix, our sort order is not helping us. And similarly, if we look up something that is not indexed, we have to check each row. As we did for the bookshelf, we can organize the data using multiple columns. A key using two or more columns is called a composite key. Now, you have to keep in mind that the column order is important to define the data layout. In this case, our first filter is the column A. We can perform a specific search or a range query to narrow down the data to examine, as we did with the author queries in our bookshelf. If we try to perform a query only using the column B, the index will not be used, since the data is sorted using A as a first component. Similarly, if we use C or D, the database has to read and check each row. So, how can we ask different questions like "give me the books by this author" and "give me the books published in this year"? To do that, there are secondary indexes. You can see them as another table sorted by the fields that you have specified and that is automatically updated on insert, update, and delete. So, when you do a query like "select the rows where C is between 70 and 150, the index will be used. And it's really fast, because the column is sorted. So, everything we said before about the binary search applies, but the index does not have the value for the other columns. So, for each row matching the query, the database has to perform a lookup on the main table. And even if the database can do clever optimization, if the result set has a lot of rows, we have to jump around the main table to retrieve the values. But there is a trick to speed up queries on a secondary index. Most of the times, on a secondary index, you look up just a few columns. If you include them in your index, you will not pay the price of jumping around in the main table, and your queries will be super fast. So the best way to design a database table or creating indexes is to know what queries you need to support. Your data layout is important. Try to define keys that group the data you are searching together. In this way, no matter if you have 1,000 or 1,000,000 records, the binary search will help the database skip most of the records. For secondary indexes, include other columns if your query does not require the full row. You'll pay a bit more on insert, update, delete, but most of the times you'll do a select, so it's better to optimize for them. Otherwise, try to keep the result set of a secondary index small. Depending on the database, there may be better indexes than the B+3. For example, if you don't do range queries, an hash index may be better, but a B+3 is not a bad default. Always think at the worst case when you are designing how the data layout should look like, and remember the bookshelves. If you have any question or want to know more, leave a comment below. And if you haven't done it yet, hit the subscribe button to be notified when the next video with more details about database indexes will be available.